This area, Jug Bay on the Patuxent River, is the largest freshwater tidal wetland in the state of Maryland. One of the unique features here is the amount of wild rice growing here, Zizania aquatica. It's one of the most important wetland plants that you can have in a freshwater marsh. Most people think of it as a major food source for migrating seed-eating birds. There we go. There they're coming right toward us. Canada geese are a big part of the wintering population of waterfowl. Thousands of them spend their winters here, but there's a group of geese that are also Canada geese, but they stay here year-round. They don't migrate. They were released by people, and they began to propagate here over the last several decades till they became a major problem. We had several thousand of these resident geese, and they grazed the rice almost out of existence, which in turn affected a numerous other species that came here to feed and fuel themselves for the long migration south.
Because wetlands are essentially the purification system for the Chesapeake Bay and for the tributaries that feed into it, when we lose an acre of wetland, we're losing that ability to filter rainwater, to filter groundwater, to have this habitat for species that desperately need it. We have about 500,000 acres of wetland that line the Chesapeake Bay proper and also the tributaries that lead into the Chesapeake Bay. Typically, you can see tidal or non-tidal wetlands. Here at Jug Bay, we're a tidal wetland. It brings with it a fresh flow of dissolved oxygen. It brings nutrients with it and also allows for the wetlands to dilute the nutrients and potentially chemicals or pollutants in the water. Climate change and sea level rise does impact wetlands. For example, what I can say is that over the last decade or so, what we're seeing at select sites here at in Jug Bay is higher than usual spikes in salinity levels and flooded waters. Now, what does this mean for the wetlands? Well, some plants are tolerant to salinity spikes and some aren't. Some are tolerant to high levels of flooding and some aren't. What we might start to see in the future is kind of like the cast of plant characters in the wetlands changing. Wild rice is not very tolerant to salinity spikes. And so if we do start to see some of those, we might start to see our wild rice stop producing its seed or maybe stop surviving altogether. And that can have great implications to the migratory fowl that depend on it.
I always like to compare this marsh to, it's kind of an ecological puzzle. If you start taking pieces of that puzzle out, the puzzle eventually falls apart.
It's really made a great comeback here. This little creek used to be wide. This was, like I said, 15 years ago, this was all open here. You could not see a blade of rice anywhere in our view, and now it's completely surrounded us.
The amount of rice here decreased from about 350 acres down to about 35 acres. So now, in the past 15 years of this work, we've been able to increase it back up to about where it was 25 years ago.
There, that's a mallard. Oh, look, there's an eagle. There's some waterfowl. Look at that. Oh, there's a bunch going up.
This is one of the largest concentrations of diversity in the state. So these wetlands next to a rainforest are probably the most productive habitats on the planet.